Onslow County Schools serves more than 25,000 students and is the second fastest growing school system in North Carolina. As a result of this growth, facilities have been expanded or built to provide for our growing number of students. In 1992, the school system maintained 27 schools, and by 2010, our district grew to 37 school sites. As our community continues to thrive, so does the increased demand for new school buildings and facilities that meet the needs of 21st century teaching and learning. The Onslow County School Board of Education, in submitting their budget, identified highest priority capital needs for our school system, totaling $149 million over the next 5 years. As a result of economic concerns and sequestration unknowns, the board refined the request to $75 million, reflecting only the most critically needed capital projects. Funding for any project takes money. Onslow County Schools receives its funding for capital projects from Onslow County. The county receives their money through taxes and the purchase of bonds, which are a type of low interest rate borrowing. However, in order to move forward in obtaining a bond, Onslow County voters must vote favorably for the referendum on November 5th during the municipal elections. This funding for capital projects covers a broad range of needs throughout the school district. Onslow County Schools recognizes the need to continue to enhance infrastructure, improving safety and security within our facilities. While improvements have been made, $6 million will be used to fund additional systems, including security for entrances and school grounds. Other improvements will involve enhanced cameras and monitoring systems, upgraded identification checks, scan card readers at entries, and the district-wide communication that will afford the safety of our children and staff in our schools. Despite ongoing efforts, Dixon Middle School and Richlands Elementary, both constructed in the 1920s, can no longer adequately support the educational needs of our 21st century learners. This district has a responsibility to provide appropriate and healthy learning environments for our students and staff. Major renovations are cost prohibitive on many levels. Renovation would require students to be relocated or housed in more than 30 temporary classrooms during the long construction period. Additionally, renovation would require reconstructing 1920s era buildings to meet 21st century building codes and require the adherence to Department of Public Instruction's health and safety guidelines. Bond funding will provide for the replacement of these two aged buildings with efficient and more economical schools while being more equitable to students in two of the largest areas of growth. Should the bond not be funded, the Dixon area stands to lose 30 acres adjoined to 10 acres acquired with 2006 bonds funds. This 30 acres could be forfeited if construction permits are not in place by May of 2015. As good stewards of our aged facilities, it is incumbent upon the Onslow County School System to maintain safe environments for students, staff, and the many community organizations with whom we share our schools. Bond funding will provide for several large repairs and replacement projects, including roofing, windows, asphalt, HVAC, and chillers at schools throughout the district. The entire bond package comes to $75 million, with each school in the county receiving funding for capital projects. Onslow County Schools has a proven track record of using bond money judiciously to build schools on time and on or under budget. Onslow County's residents enjoy low property taxes. We are the 66th lowest in our state of 100 counties, while according to the Bureau of Economic Analysis, our county ranks third highest per capita income in the state. If an increase in property tax is needed, it would only result in a very modest increase of $2.83 a month, or $34 a year for properties valued at $100,000. The municipal election is Tuesday, November 5th. If you want more information on the bond, consult our website. Make an informed decision by getting all the facts. And please, vote on election day.